feels so good. You're lying here next to me.
Lyngdorf, the company that brought you Wife Safe. Patent pending.
Or utilize the genius of boundary woofer technology perfected by Lyngdorf that comes in as a way to get huge performance from small speaker systems.
The question is, what exactly happens if we add two of their BW2 woofers and set them up perfectly in this room? That's a practical experiment really worth doing now that we have a real-life idea of the standalone performance of the Q100s, sound pressure-wise. The great benefit of boundary setups is very good bass distribution, not really possible with a single subwoofer. By placing woofers in each corner of the room, we also fight room modes that can affect bass performance in the listening position. Another great benefit of corner placing the woofers is the significant acoustical gain you get there, usually more than 6 dB of extra gain. For perspective, 6 dB more gain is equal to getting a 3 times more powerful amplifier for free. Yes, work smarter, not harder, right? Most importantly, by adding two woofers, we can take a tremendous load off the small drivers here. Usually, common wisdom is that you will have to use rather low crossover frequencies like 80 or 100 Hz with subwoofers in order for the brain not to detect the placement of the sub. But when using boundary woofers, this problem is eliminated as we now have symmetry and a woofer for each side, allowing us to use much higher crossover frequencies, in this case as high as 160 Hz, thus unloading the Q100 woofer almost completely and letting the woofers in the BW2s do all the tough work. Naturally, the 3400 integrated amplifier is key to getting all that to work perfectly. It has massive amounts of power to unlock the full potential of the relatively low efficiency Q100, we might say, and Lyngdorf engineer derived preset settings to set everything up easily. The BW2 woofer is a very slim package, easy to place in a corner, behind a curtain, or somewhere else without making any big visual noise in the decor. There are presets provided and a diagram showing you where to connect the speakers and the woofers. Next, you will want to take advantage of the built-in room-perfect room correction system in the 3400. It's a great and musical system overall that also ensures perfect woofer integration and can compensate for less than optimal speaker placements. To do the room measurements, you simply follow the guide and move the supplied microphone. After running Room Perfect with two BW2 woofers added to the mix, a brand new beast of a setup is revealed. Since the Q100 speakers are offloaded so much, with all the bass energy being directed to woofers, they now retain their clarity and effortlessness even at much, much higher volumes. I do the Lisso vacuum cleaning test and get at least 15 dB more headroom. In real life, in this room, on a music night, I carry out the wifey test using my wife's interesting playlists, quickly resulting in... which is something that only happens if she gets moved by the actual sound or wants to impress other men present in the room. But in this case, only I and the dog and the Q100 setup was present, so I take it was the Lyngdorf sound. The ability to add that kind of performance lift, if needed, is simply an underrated Lyngdorf technology trademark. While it's possible to mimic with other systems, I've never experienced it working as well as it does with these systems. Thanks to Room Perfect and good engineering, the results are always seamless, natural sounding, and easy to achieve, allowing for an amazing real-world flexibility that I find very impressive in light of all the other systems I try and test on a regular basis. On top of the room-perfected sound, we can also add a voicing filter from built-in presets or create our own, allowing for tailoring the sound to your exact preferences. Voicing filters are not just a simple tone control, they are 8-band, super flexible professional EQs capable of fine-tuning any aspect of the frequency spectrum, allowing you to achieve just the sound tuning you want. I gave the CUE-100s the full Sternholm dating treatment to slowly discover what these ladies are all about. I used them standalone with a load-powered amp with another room correction system, tried different placements, used them as standalone shelf speakers with a fully analog setup with powerful amplifiers, and then turned to the Lyngdorf ecosystem using the 3400 integrated amplifier with standalone CUE-100s first. Lastly, I did the boundary woofer setup for the final exam of the young, well-dressed ladies. The resulting sound in each case is very Lyngdorf. Here you get a correct, dry and tight sound, leaning to the conservative side in my ears. There's no coloring, no spices that don't belong added. Even if it can be viewed as sounding negative to some, the truth is that the soul of the sound is that of an accountant, which goal is to achieve perfect accounting reconciliation. This is a good thing and offers a fine balance that works with any kind of music. In short, natural sounding, but restricting the creativity in translation, if we can call it that, that is what gives other systems their personas, whether you like them or not.
When we make speakers, when we make amplifiers, we try to reproduce what's on the recording in your living room and nothing else.
If the Lyngdorf system was a wife, she would be disciplined, but can be talked into wearing a bit more makeup, but it will always be tasteful. You will never see her twerking on the dance floor, wearing a G-string or dressed up in pink boots and short shirt, showing anything other than an elegant hint of cleavage. But here's the thing. You can always count on her, and she is capable of lifting heavy weights, run a half marathon, and keep up composure every day and in every aspect of life. She's neither a nun or a whore. I found the CUE-100 to be extremely good and safe sounding together with Lyngdorf electronics, especially with voices. That sounds amazing. You can listen for hours without any fatigue. No matter what I threw at them, they deliver dynamics and the spunk of the music. I feel they can lack some finer microdynamics and texture in comparison with a speaker like the Reitho TD1.2 previously tested here on the channel. But then again, the CUE-100s can take on much larger rooms and give you more sense of scale. The highs are never excessive, no matter the challenge. On the very challenging 2L recording of the Cantus Choir performing Kyria, that brings many a speaker to their knees in the top end, I'm really impressed with how well that AMT tweeter just holds up. At lower volumes, I find the CUE-100 to be less articulated than when playing it at a bit higher volumes. In essence, they need a little juice to really open up, or a little help from the tone control. When combined with the 3400 amplifier and the BWV2 woofers and the smart factory settings, of course, you can push the speakers quite hard while the system maintains control through limiters, preventing it from being pushed beyond its limits. In fact, what happens is that you gradually lose dynamic range, indicating when it's time to ease a bit off. The Lyngdorf guys, they seem to have thought of everything here. The true sound nirvana, eargasm, for me, was achieved with this setup, listening to music like Mighty Mo Rogers and his The Boy Who Stole the Blues, Boris Blank and Malia on Celestial Echo. Check that album. It was totally missed by me until recently, and what a sonic delight. It sounds crazy. Other perfect selections was tracks like D'Angelo's Africa and Prince, When the Lights Go Down and such, all played at reasonably spirited levels, utilizing the boundary setup. The soundstage the system renders when placed freestanding was calm and deep and precise. You can always find all music mentioned here in the reviews on the Sonic Snacks playlist, linked to in the video description. That in itself is a treasure trove of information with nobody trying to sell you anything. So don't be afraid to dip your toes in there. The CUE-100 is a lifestyle-friendly designer speaker that excels in sound performance without compromising on aesthetics, unlike many other designer systems. It seamlessly blends into various decor styles thanks to its range of color options. There's no doubt that this speaker is really suitable for many scenarios where large and bulky speakers are undesired, but where sound quality remains a priority for music lovers. Personally, I find the design of the CUE-100 to be original and visually appealing. One important aspect to consider is the speaker's pretty low 83 dB efficiency. It can require some muscle from the amplifier to unlock its best performance. As a full-range speaker, the CUE-100 offers next-level performance compared to other high-end compact two-way speakers I have reviewed. It delivers a dry, well-balanced sound overall with impressive bass performance that rivals or even surpasses that of many floor-standing speakers within the CUE-100's sound pressure level limits. If you desire more loudness, I recommend adding a couple of boundary woofers, preferably from Lyngdorf along with Lyngdorf electronics, as all the built-in tricks really brings the best out of such system and makes it easy to achieve excellent results. So now let's address the elephant in the room, the price. A pair of either black or white CUE-100 speakers, that always includes the stands, cost 20,000 euros a pair. There are optional editions like the oak base for a 1,000 euros extra and the Gabriel fabric covers that cost 1,500 euros. The CUE-100 occupies a unique space in the market, as there really ain't many Scandinavian designed luxury high-end speakers catering to the lifestyle segment. Although not direct competitors, it's worth mentioning the Reitho TD1.2 compact speakers, which cost 25,000 euros for a pair in wood finish, including stands. While the Reitho speakers lack a front fabric option, they can still be customized in terms of cabinet colors. However, their sound pressure level performance is significantly lower compared to the CUE-100, thus not being the more all-round performer you get with the CUE-100. Going cheap for half the price, there could be compact speakers like the Bowers & Wilkins 805D4 Signature, but good luck with the interior designer wear partner on those, and again, the bass extension and sound pressure performance is nowhere near the CUE-100. In fact, I think we have to look towards professional studio monitor style speakers like the Genelec 8351A active monitors to get sound pressure performance that can really exceed the CUE-100s. But a pair of 8351s on a Genelec floor stand with a lot of cables running up and down will probably get you sleeping on the couch, but they will only set you back around 8,000 euros plus an upgrade to the couch maybe. So there you have it. If you don't want to compromise and want that happy wife, happy life at the same time, There really ain't much that can deliver on all fronts like the CUE-100 can. Now, get out there and listen to a pair while remembering that nothing can replace your own experience. Hear what the CUE-100 can do for you in your own room with your music. Any good reseller should be able to arrange for a home listening with speakers like this. Stand by for the pros, the cons, and the review score, and remember to tap, tap, tap those like and subscribe buttons and check out all the other awesome content on the channel. Share videos that you find interesting with others in the audiophile forums and social media out there. See you soon here back on the channel, and remember, you will know everything if you just listen.